Hi, I'm John Federico. I'm in Windows Server and Azure Product Marketing here at Microsoft, and I'm responsible for remote desktop services and Windows Virtual Desktop. Today, we're going to dive into a variety of topics around remote desktop services, or RDS. First, we will talk about what's improved in the core product of RDS, both 2016 and 2019, and you can use these wherever you are, whether it's on-premises or on the cloud. We released the newest version of Remote Desktop Services, RDS 2019, in October of 2019 with Windows Server. RDS 2019 builds on the strong foundation of RDS 2016, letting you rapidly deploy on-premises or in the cloud. In addition to the core investments we've made in RDS 2016, we recognize there's still an opportunity to improve the non-persistent and complex virtualization environments at scale that we see with our customers today. So we'll talk about an acquisition of FS Logix, the product line, and how you can leverage all of the benefits in your RDS environment today. Third, we also want to walk you through how to think about RDS in different ways as you begin leveraging the cloud. You do not need to just lift and shift your environment. Instead, you can use Azure in a way that makes sense for you. And lastly, one of those specific strategies we will go into in more depth may be to leverage Windows Virtual Desktop, easing the amount of RDS infrastructure that you have to manage as part of your desktop virtualization environment. So, let's dive into what's new with RDS 2016 and 2019. So first, we understand that you still may be running workloads on 2008 or 2012, but we added a ton of value on our past two RDS releases that really help improve the experience. First, there's the connection broker. So we heard that it was difficult to scale, both in terms of pure connection load, but also in setting it up. So we've increased scale during login waves, including support for 2+ instances for high availability and connecting with SQL auth. For the gateway, we heard that you use any number of third-party firewalls and load balancers. So we wanted to make the gateway as flexible as possible, with functionality being like using existing installed certificates. And then with the license server, we've time and time again heard from customers that license management should focus on simplification to scale deployments. Over the past few years, we have focused on improving management of RD licensing servers and entitlement through Active Directory. Now, you will be able to leverage high availability RD licensing servers with forward compatibility for future versions of Windows Server to enable easier management of licenses from a variety of RDS releases. We've also made it easier to manage licenses for your employees by bringing the ability for the RD licensing servers to update RDS client access licenses, or CALs, into AD objects without accessing Active Directory directly. Lastly, we've added perfmon, or performance counter, APIs to provide partners an easy way to access data to build monitoring dashboards and deliver a consistent user experience. So let's talk a little bit about the web client. We also added web client support for single sign-on to deliver a streamlined authentication experience for users connecting via the web client, which we hear is very common today. We've also added modern notifications for the remote app in an Action Center to improve productivity with applications you use every day, like Microsoft Outlook. And then for clients, how you access the service, in case you didn't know, we have Mac, iOS, Android, web, as well as Windows clients that you've come to love and use every day. For iOS in particular, we've added support for a partner SwiftPoint mouse. And in Android, we integrated support for Samsung's DeX offering to deliver remote desktops and apps through their devices. Around the RDP protocol in particular, we've made some updates. We added high-level redirection of built-in or attached video cameras to deliver optimized video stream at higher frame rates in new and legacy remote apps and desktops. So now users can have a better experience with video-intensive interactions. With RD Session Host, we've made several optimizations to Windows Defender for multi-session to give you more confidence in bringing a secure, scalable, and cost-effective desktop experience to end users. We've also made optimizations to advanced threat protection, ATP Exploit Guard, application control, Windows Admin Center, which specifically we want to call out that it's easy to now consolidate all of your local and remote server management into a single pane using the Windows server you have already today. And a few additional features include easy-to-configure DTLS-based encryption, all of which work toward providing a trusted end-to-end RDS deployment. And then on GPU functionality, RDS session hosts are now load-balanced across available GPUs. And we have also improved upon innovations in discrete device assignment in RDS 2016 to bring better virtual machine isolation and performance for your graphic-intensive workloads. These improvements in GPU virtualization tech will result in reduced network traffic and smooth video playback for your users. So, we've talked a little bit about what we've done natively to build into RDS on Windows Server, but now we want to discuss new functionality for non-persistent environments, where we typically had a huge reliance on our partners to solve key functionality gaps that were important to your users. Now, with FS Logix, we were bringing that functionality into the native RDS experience. So, in November, we acquired FS Logix to primarily enhance the office experience, but the suite of their technologies, including their profile containers, help all non-persistent environments and overall application management in totality. So, what do they offer and what's the suite look like? So, there have been numerous solutions throughout the industry to try and solve the problem of always getting your profile in non-persistent environments. The profile container technology that they created simplifies that experience and allows you to use your applications like Office, like you do today. Application masking, which currently helps deal with manageability and maintainability of the number of images, sometimes upwards of a few thousand if you're a large enterprise, can help simplify how you're managing a complex set of apps for your users. And then Java redirection, which just ultimately helps with different versions of Java that you might have to maintain in your environment today. So let's specifically dive into profile containers. Profile containers historically have helped in running desktops and apps in non-persistent environments and eliminated the difficulties that were presented in moving and roaming profiles of users between different VMs as they logged on and logged off of VMs between different days, different parts of the week, and making sure that that experience that your employees get is a persistent look and feel with the scale of RDS compared to a traditional VDI. So this is where the profile containers can help. It is similar in design to UPD, but it is a strong offering that enables mounting of a VHD file to the VM as users roam. So when a user logs on, that VHD will mount to that VM, and when they're done, it will be stored in a specific centralized storage location that you can dictate. And when they log on again, it'll be mounted to that next VM. So it allows you in a non-persistent environment like in RDS, as well as some scenarios we'll talk about with Windows Virtual Desktop, to provide a persistent look and feel with a non-persistent scale and backend. Now, Office 365 containers are a subset of the profile containers we just discussed, but specifically for Office 365 cache data. They help to enable functionality such as roaming of Outlook OST files, OneDrive cache, and Windows search to make the user experience personalized despite the non-persistent virtual desktop and app experience that they may have provisioned to them. This really specifically targets the Office experience, which we know has not always been the best in a remote desktop scenario. And application masking. Again, there are different ways to solve the number of images problem that enterprises and companies of all sizes are impacted by today. Application masking is an approach that enables application management through installation of a base image. All you need to do here is install the application. Then you can reveal only the apps that you have entitled for a user, and this can be changed in real time. This approach will help simplify your app management through a consolidation of base or golden images that need to be maintained for different sets of users, ultimately simplifying and consolidating what IT needs to manage on the back end to provide desktops and apps to end users. And then ultimately, Java. We understand that there are supportive apps with different Java versions of the same base images are necessary. Coupled with app masking, you can hide unused versions of Java, but provide it on one centralized base image so that you don't have to manage different apps or golden images with different forms of Java and deciding how to make sure you're appropriately keeping them updated. This is where Java redirection can help. So, we've talked a lot about what the functionality of different technologies in this suite or profile container set can do, but we're first going to now talk about how their support and consistency across the totality of your environment. And that's really what we want to focus on with Microsoft and providing this technology in our RDS environments. Consistency. You can use the same profile format across on-prem and on the cloud. And we'll get to licensing in a little bit, so you'll see how easy it is to bring it out to your entire environment immediately. Client and server. We understand that you're currently running RDS, but you also might have some VDI environment. You want to have one set of user profile formatting across your entire environment. And this ultimately provides consistency across not only end user experience, but also flexibility and consistency from an IT perspective for hybrid scenarios and understanding how you can manage that consistent user experience no matter where you're running those workloads. And the best news, you're likely already entitled if you're virtualizing desktops and apps today. As you can see, the Remote Desktop Services Client Access License, or CAL, gives you the entitlement to FSLogic's technology, and we're working on an integration plan as we speak. You also have access through a variety of Windows Enterprise licenses, as you can see there as well, including E3, E5, VDA, and a variety of other Microsoft 365 licensing options. So, in a nutshell, the FSLogic's technologies provide consistency wherever you are. And what that really will help you do is decide and maintain a larger, more complex remote desktop environment. So, now that we've covered the amazing benefits of FSLogic to create consistency and strength in your end user experience across your environment, let's talk about how to think about extending or migrating your RDS deployment to Azure as you assess your broader move to cloud. These are a few common scenarios that we have seen, and as you'll notice, there are different ways to think about how you can use Azure in regards to your RDS environment. In the first one, you see, you have an extend motion in a burst to cloud model that leverages Azure to scale up above your on-prem environment capacity as needed. In the second scenario, you can see a disaster recovery model where you can replicate your environment on Azure so that you can have a complete backup when needed. In the third model, this is where we're starting to talk about migration in the more pure sense. And this is where you're running RDS on an IaaS model on Azure through a lift and shift of your RD session host and infrastructure roles to Azure. In this scenario, just so you know, you can also manage the infrastructure roles and the VMs in Azure, but you can flexibly run the VMs themselves on-prem. So that provides you an opportunity for some flexibility on how you want to manage your RD infrastructure roles and your session hosts. And then on the furthest option of lift and shift in a migration, you see Windows Virtual Desktop. And this is where we have infrastructure management, such as Gateway, Broker, and Diagnostics, managed by Microsoft, us, as a service on Azure. Your entire environment is on Azure, including the VMs, but you have simplified management of the infrastructure to focus on what matters most to you, managing the desktops and apps for your employees. And for our partners, we'll get into that a lot more now, but ultimately, with Windows Virtual Desktop and Remote Desktop Services, we made a lot of expansions and improvements to how we bring partners in and develop a large partner ecosystem. We announced availability of Remote Desktop Services subscriptions, or RDS CAL subscriptions, through the Cloud Solution Provider Program, CSP. The availability of RDS and CSP addresses customer needs for additional cost-effective solutions that support desktop and app virtualization. With RDS subscriptions, partner can now directly sell RDS subscriptions through CSP program, eliminating the extra step of customers and partners acquiring different licenses through different licensing programs. With this model, now you customers can enjoy a faster licensing cycle due to CSP integration with other Microsoft licenses, including Windows Server, SQL Server, and Office, to make it easy for partners to simplify the buying process. We also have a strong partner ecosystem that continue to leverage partners like Citrix and VMware to run your RDS environment on-premises, hybrid, or fully on Azure with Windows Virtual Desktop. So, I've been talking a lot about Windows Virtual Desktop as a longer-term Azure solution. So, what is that? So, now I'm going to dive into the brand new Windows Virtual Desktop that we announced at Ignite. There are four key pillars. I want to emphasize, though, most importantly, that you can bring your existing RDS environment with no rebuilding required with a simplified management of Microsoft managing the infrastructure roles as a service in our subscription in Azure. But you also can deliver the only multi-session Windows 10 experience and have optimizations for Office 365 Pro Plus, including those FSLogic technologies we already talked about, as well as new functionality that the engineering teams of Office and the remote desktop team with Windows Virtual Desktop have built into this new Windows 10 multi-session. Because Windows 10 multi-session plus Office 365 Pro Plus can provide the best desktop experience, but we want to make sure you understand that remote desktop services can be brought and lifted into Windows Virtual Desktop as is. And then if you want, you can modernize workloads as you see fit. And you can simplify desktops and apps all in one. So, as you see on the right in this diagram, there's the traditional setup of a remote desktop environment. And you see on the at the very top, there's the remote infrastructure roles. And that would be the traditional RD infrastructure roles that we were just talking about earlier in this discussion, but also are more that we provide as a service. So that's the web access, the diagnostics, the gateway. Those are the things that Microsoft is now managing as a platform within Azure in our tenant. And you no longer have to host, configure, and deploy those to each of your environments. We also are managing all of the difficult on-premise infrastructure in our Azure data centers. So you can you have the ability to stop deciding on how to forecast your end user computing needs through a data center capacity. So what do you have to really focus on? Now all you have to focus on is the desktops and apps that you provide to your customers or to your end users. You utilize Azure Active Directory for an identity management. You can deploy and manage your VMs in Azure, as well as you only deploy desktops and apps, or any combination of the two. So we've talked about how you can run your RDS environment on-prem or in hybrid. This is a purely Azure model, but it allows you to have streamlined management to really provide a differentiated, more scalable, and flexible solution for your desktops and apps long-term as you assess and migrate to cloud. So how do you have access to it? Just like with FS Logix technology, you are very likely already entitled to this. With the RDS CAL, or the Client Access License with Active Software Assurance, you can run this service today. You can also run Windows client operating systems such as Windows 7, Windows 10, and this new Windows 10 multi-session capability in Windows Virtual Desktop with your existing Windows Enterprise licenses. So you have two options that you can really use to provide Windows Virtual Desktop. You can provide a server operating system with your existing RDS CAL with SA. You can provide a Windows client operating system with Windows 7 with free extended security updates, Windows 10, and the brand new multi-session Windows 10 that's exclusive to Windows Virtual Desktop, all within one environment where you can provide desktops and apps, combinations of different operating systems of Windows client and Windows server, all with the licenses you probably already have today. So this is a great opportunity for an Azure and cloud-first story for your remote desktop environment as you start to think about the cloud-ready workloads. To summarize, we've continued making investments to the core RDS technology in Windows Server since Windows Server 2012 R2. In addition to the core investments we've made in RDS 2016 and 2019, we've listened to customers and acquired technology that we can integrate into the RDS platform for broad usage wherever your workload runs. And these technologies are available wherever you need them so you can provide a consistent platform. When you're running your RDS workload in the cloud, the best option is to run it with Windows Virtual Desktop, where Microsoft will take a bunch of these difficult management of the infrastructure off of your hands and manage it as a service. And as a call to action from this, there are three big points to take away. Modernize your existing Windows Server 2008 environment with free extended security updates on Azure, whether you want to run that in an IaaS model or you want to leverage a partner such as Citrix or VMware and use their existing management components as well. Begin integrating FS Logix to provide a consistent format across your environment and make your user profile experience consistent across everything you're running. And start testing Windows Virtual Desktop for cloud-ready workloads. And you can visit that link to get started in preview today. And thank you. This was an amazing opportunity to talk about all the new improvements in remote desktop services and the new Windows Virtual Desktop on Azure. Thank you.